Welcome to a lesson on classifying polygons. The goals of the video are to classify a simple polygon based upon the number of sides, and then also to investigate the number of diagonals a polygon has. For a quick review, in the intro video we defined a polygon as a plane figure made up of segments joined at the endpoints. And we said there were two types of polygons, simple polygons and complex polygons. Simple polygons have sides that do not intersect each other, as we see here, and a complex polygon has sides that intersect, as we see here in this polygon. And then there were two classifications of simple polygons, convex polygons and concave polygons. These two were convex polygons because all the diagonals would be inside the polygon, and this would be a concave polygon because some of the diagonals would be outside the polygon. But you can also think of it as two or more sides caving in to the interior of the polygon, as we see here in this region. And then these two figures down here were not polygons, this one because one edge is curved, not a line segment, and this one because not all of the segments are joined at the endpoints. Now, there are specific names for polygons based upon the number of sides the polygon contains. The polygon has three sides, it's called a triangle, four sides, a quadrilateral, five sides, a pentagon, six sides, a hexagon, seven sides, a heptagon, eight sides, an octagon, nine sides, a nonagon, 10 sides, a decagon, and there are more names. But just remember, all of these are special names for the bigger group of polygons. So they're all polygons, but within the set of polygons, we can name each polygon by the number of sides it contains. And we also talked about diagonals in the introductory video, but let's do a quick review before we take a look at determining how many diagonals a polygon actually has. The diagonals of a polygon are the line segments that connect non-adjacent vertices of a polygon. So the vertices of the polygon are where the segments join each other. This has five vertices. And the segments making up the polygon are called the edges or sides. So if we wanted to sketch the diagonals from this vertex here, these two would be the adjacent vertices. So we'd have a diagonal here and a diagonal here from this vertex. Now if we go around to each vertex, we can sketch additional diagonals, but we'll go ahead and stop here. But notice for a pentagon, there will be two diagonals from each vertex. Let's go ahead and sketch the diagonals from one vertex of this concave hexagon. If we select this vertex here, we would have a diagonal here, here, and here. Notice that for a hexagon, there are three diagonals from each vertex. So let's go and take a look at the diagonals from a variety of polygons and see if we can compare the number of sides to the number of diagonals. Well, here we have a triangle with three sides, but if we select a vertex, the remaining vertices are adjacent to the selected vertex. So if there are three sides, there are actually zero diagonals. For a square, if we select this vertex, there's only one non-adjacent vertex, and that would be this one here. So there's one diagonal from this vertex, and it'd be another diagonal from this vertex here. There are no other diagonals for this quadrilateral. So if there are four sides, there are two diagonals. And we started this one on the previous screen. We said from each vertex there will be two diagonals. So there's one here and one here from this vertex, one here and one here from this vertex. And then we go to this vertex, there's already one sketched here, but we do have to sketch one more connecting these two vertices. And then looking at the remaining vertices, there are already two diagonals emanating from those vertices. So let's go ahead and count these. We've got to be careful here not to count them more than once. So we have one here, one here, one here, one here, and one here. So there are a total of five diagonals for a pentagon. So if it has five sides, it has five diagonals. Here we have a hexagon. So we'll start here at this vertex. We have one, two, three diagonals from each vertex. So if we go to this vertex here, we have 1, 2, and 3. This is going to get much more difficult to count. Let's go ahead and keep track of it. So far we have 6. From this vertex we only have 1, 2 more that we can sketch, so there's 2 more. Again, it's helpful to remember there are 3 diagonals from each vertex. Looking at this vertex, there's already 2 sketched, so we have 1 more here, so that's 1 more. And then the remaining vertices already have 3 diagonals sketched. So when we have 6 sides, there are 9 diagonals. Now let's go ahead and take a look at a couple more. Maybe we can see a pattern. Here we have a polygon with 7 sides, or a heptagon. So each vertex will have 1, 2, 3, 4 diagonals emanating from it. So there's 4. We'll have another 4 from this vertex. That'll give us a total of 8 so far. Now this vertex has 1 already sketched, so that'll be 3 more. 1, 2, 3. This vertex has 2 already, so we can sketch 2 additional diagonals. 1 here and 1 here. You can see it's getting messy. This vertex has 1, 2, 3 diagonals already, so there's 1 more. That would be this one here. This one already has 1, 2, 3, 4, and this one already has 1, 2, 3, 4. So if there are 7 sides, there are 14 diagonals. I'm going to go ahead and stop here. You may want to investigate this further yourself. It is a fairly challenging formula to develop from this pattern, but the formula is n times the quantity n minus 3 divided by 2, where n is the number of sides. So we left off with the heptagon, but if we had an octagon, but the number of diagonals for an octagon, or a polygon that has 8 sides, would tell us that n is equal to 8. So the number of diagonals would be 8 times 8 minus 3 divided by 2. This is going to be 8 times 5. It's 40 divided by 2, that's 20 diagonals. So if you have the time, you may want to see if you can sketch all 20 diagonals for the octagon. We'll go ahead and stop here for this video. I hope you found this helpful.